I'll tell you a story that happened to me. One day as I went down the yard by the sea, the sun it was bright and the day it was warm. Says I, a quiet pint wouldn't do me no harm. I went into the barman, I said, give me a stout. Says the barman, I'm sorry, all the beer to sold out. Try whiskey or vodka, 10 years in the wood. Says I, I'll try cider, I've heard that it's good. Oh never, oh never, oh never again. If I live to 100...
All public events now in American life seem to devolve in the same way into the same thing. They're all just amateur night, you know, where people go out and get hammered and march around on the street and tear stuff up. And to the degree that that's associated with my ethnic background or my religion, I think is unfortunate.
I fell to the ground and I couldn't get up after drinking a pint of the Johnny Jumper.
My family came from Ireland a couple of generations ago and migrated to Holyoke. We thought of ourselves as being Irish. It was a big part of our identity. It rotated around the church. Foremost, St. Patrick's Day was a religious holiday. It just was not what we think of now. It was much more like what St. Patrick's Day is celebrated in traditional Ireland, in the country.
Like what I know of, like St. Patrick, he was actually a slave in his younger days. He's from the west of the mainland in the UK, and was brought over to Ireland as a slave and then back. But he came back in his later life, brought Christianity to Ireland. A lot of people know St. Patrick is famous for chasing the snakes out of Ireland. And some people think that's literally, but the whole story behind that is St. Patrick chased the pagans out of Ireland because he brought Christianity, and the snake was the pagan symbol. So he's renowned for chasing the snakes out of the country and brought the first real religion to Ireland.
In Dublin next arrived, I thought it such a pity to be so soon deprived of you of that
white city. Religion doesn't really come in to the equation in the south of Ireland. It's your Irish and that's it. Whereas in the north, the whole thing comes in. People see themselves as British and other people see themselves as Irish. So you have this sort of debate of St. Patrick's an Irish saint, so they don't class him as being like their patron saint. Because, and then that's where they label him like he's an Irish saint, so he's Catholic.
It is a Catholic holiday. I would not want to speculate as to what goes on in Northern Ireland. I can only tell you that the brand of Protestantism that they celebrate there would have no theological connection to saints to begin with. And I would imagine it's one of the ways that they distinguish themselves. But that's not something I would speculate on. You start speculating about that stuff, you can get yourself into it. You can find yourself on the wrong end of the argument very quickly.
So you see in there St. Peter's Close, that's one of the cathedrals. And just here on the right hand side, this we're coming up to one of the peace walls. This is like the international peace wall. It like has a lot of different, it's not just like about Irish politics and things. You might see on the wall, so you have like the political prisoners of Palestine. And then you also have a lot of things through the Troubles, which have all happened, like the internment is like when the British put Republicans in jail without trial. There was no trial, just straight to jail. And we'll have like Nelson Mandela. It's more or less anyone who's like stood up for like their rights and freedom fighters throughout time.
Right.
We even have a little kick at the Americans on this somewhere.
They're always happy to see Yanks because they like Americans, but they know we're Americans. and it's particularly, now things have changed somewhat. Ireland is a much more cosmopolitan, a much wealthier world than it was 30 or 40 years ago. The bonds of culture and memory are strong, but they are Irish and we are Irish American.
Why is America celebrating Patrick's Day bigger than what we are, kind of thing? I think because there is such a big Irish heritage in America, and a lot of people want to hold on to that heritage, they would go all out and go even bigger than what we would here. I think St. Patrick's Day would probably be seen as a bigger deal in America than what it would be in Ireland.
In Ireland now, it's interesting, they now have a big St. Patrick's Day parade, which was really set up to mimic what they were doing in New York and Boston and in the States, and is just a big holiday. And again, part of that is a reflection, first of all, of the sort of cultural backwash from the States, but it's also a sign that Ireland is changing. Ireland in the 1950s and the 1960s, it would have been a holy day in the middle of Lent. It was a holy day in the middle of Lent. What, I mean, you can't make a more boring holiday than that.
Well, Dublin's a bit different because it has a big enough parade and things, but I'd still say the parades in like Boston, New York, Chicago and stuff would probably be like 10 times bigger than anything that we would celebrate over here.
That started in the United States as a celebration of political power, then slowly but surely transmuted itself into a celebration, I guess, of spring and having a good time, and somehow mentally associated with Mardi Gras, I guess, I don't know, you know, and now just sort of a celebration of Irishness and kiss me, I'm Irish and everybody's Irish, and everybody celebrates it in roughly the same way, which is nothing like the Irish used to celebrate.
Living in Northern Ireland, we are run by the British government. So one half of our community wants to remain British and remain part of the UK, where the other half of our community will want to be Irish and have United Ireland. So the Protestant, it's normally, it's not always, it's the but majority Protestant community want to remain part of the United Kingdom, whereas mainly Catholics want to remain part of the whole of Ireland. But because we are like run by the UK, a lot of like unionist politicians don't agree that we celebrate and spend government money on an Irish celebration.
So, and you see that the police themselves are heavily armed. It's not as if they're just standing with buttons. They're all like armed with machine guns and riot gear. So that's every night that happens. So it's just becomes the norm.
Everyone does, I know even here, everyone just sees St. Patrick's Day as like a big drinking session kind of thing. And oh, it's Irish culture, we're just going to go get drunk. But a lot of the thing I see about St. Patrick's Day, it is about culture. It's like supporting our Irish heritage through the sports, which is why the Gaelic and football hurlings are held on that day. And also like through the music, Irish music is like world renowned, like pop artists as well, but their traditional music comes to the forefront. It is a day where people sort of remember their roots as well. And I think that might be some of that actually I know happens in like New York and things as well. But I think for Irish people here, it is a day that you sort of remember that you are Irish and we do have our own sort of separate culture that isn't part of the UK as well. And it's like nowhere else around the world has the sort of, especially I think the musical and like arts culture that we would have here in Ireland.
Eyes well peeled today, the tall, tall men, they're on their way, they're searching for the mountain day in the hills of Connemara. Gather up the pots and the old tin can.